Okay, what I'll do is ask if there's anyone who wants to make a presentation or bring an item forward under the open forum portion of our meeting. Is there anyone? Is there anything you want to bring forward here?
Ian.
Okay.
On my mind right now?
No.
Okay, thank you. And I thank members of council.
3H.
Yeah.
Okay, Mr. Nohammer, if you could bring us up to date.
Certainly, Mr. Mayor. So there was one deputation request received this afternoon from Ms. Lori Smith regarding recreational vehicles, and that's item 7 on your agenda related to the Committee of the Whole minutes of September 28th. And within that minutes, it was item number 14.
Okay. So we'll deal with that separately then. Is there a new format here on the agenda? New format? Maybe not, eh? Yeah. I'm not used to seeing it that blank.
Items have been activated on our screen yet.
Oh, okay. So when she starts the meeting, then we'll see.
Okay. So we'll know.
Okay.
Okay. That makes sense. Let me know when we're ready, or is it now? Is it? I have 7. Yeah, I have 7 o'clock there now.
Good evening and welcome to the council meeting of the town of Newmarket on Monday, October the 5th, 2015. All members of council are present with the exception of Councillor Hempen, and Mayor Van Bynen is presiding.
Thank you very much. There are no public notices required at this point. We did have one addendum, and that was with respect to a deputation request as outlined earlier. So could I please have a motion to add the addendum item to our agenda? Councillor Kerwin, Councillor Twinney, all those in favor? That is carried. Are there any declarations of pecuniary interest? Being none then, let's go directly to the deputations. And the deputation is a request from Lori Smith, is it? Lori, we permit up to 5 minutes, and we'll deal with the item shortly after, okay?
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and councillors. First, I would like to begin by saying thank you for hearing me out time and time again regarding this bylaw. I know that it has been difficult to try to please everyone, and I appreciate you listening to some of my thoughts and ideas. From the last meeting, there were many differing opinions, which led me to think more about how we are really going to be fair to accommodate everyone's different needs regarding the parking of trailers and RVs. Keep in mind, I said parking and not storing. By allowing seasonal parking, meaning in the summer, I could have my boat parked on my driveway, would not mean I'm storing it there. I'm simply parking it there till I go to use it the next weekend use. Come the winter, I would not have my boat stored on my driveway. It would be stored in my garage or elsewhere for the winter. Vice versa for snowmobiles, parked on driveways for winter and stored elsewhere for summer. Councillor Kerwin made a good point saying times have changed and recreational vehicles are now longer, bigger. Our bylaws should change to the 21st century. Why would we leave ancient wording in there? I agree, this is an ancient bylaw, and times have changed, and so have people's needs. Therefore, I have thought of one more suggestion to bring to the council. The council has agreed to an 8-day parking allowance for trailers and recreational vehicles as long as they are set back 1 meter from the road from sight lines restrictions. This helps those who have larger, bigger recreational vehicles, trailers. Well, I'm asking that council considers those who have smaller recreational vehicles, trailers, such as tent trailers, boats, etc., that are within the current length restrictions be allowed to have a seasonal parking option, as it would be no different than having a vehicle parked in my driveway. You should consider the fact that if times have changed for larger trailers and RVs, that so has the time for more and more use of these smaller trailers and RVs. So let's get with the times of the 21st century and allow for seasonal parking of vehicle-sized trailers and RVs. I have knocked on several doors in the town of Newmarket since the last meeting to advise those with trailers and RVs to speak to their counselors, as those who I spoke to were unaware of this bylaw and were shocked to learn that we are not allowed to park RVs and trailers on our private driveways. Some even said if they were not allowed to park recreational vehicles or trailers on their property, it would be detrimental to their outdoor family lifestyle. I feel that council's decision has likely been made, but I'm here to ask you all one last time to consider a seasonal option with size restrictions. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any questions of clarification of the deputy? There being none then, could I have a motion to receive the deputation? Councillor Sponda, Councillor Broome-Plumley. All those in favour? That is carried. Thank you.
Thank you.
What I'd like to do then is, with Council's indulgence, bring forward item number 14 of our Committee of the Whole, September the 28th, and that is report number 2015-39 from our Planning and Building Services Department, and it is with respect to recreational vehicles in residential zones. Could I have someone to bring to deal with the recommendations? Could I have a motion? Councillor Twinney, Regional Councillor. Any discussion? It may be appropriate, Madam Commissioner, if we could just outline the changes that were implemented as a result of some of the feedback that we had received. Mm-hmm. And I think that's captured in the amendments because we did receive and we did adopt an alternate recommendation. Madam Commissioner?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Would you like me to if I can refer right to the bylaw, because the bylaw does capture all of the changes. So would you like me just to review that?
Sure, if that's the most effective summary, that would be appreciated.
So the bylaw that is before Council this evening, which is bylaw 2015-47, does outline that one recreation vehicle or utility trailer can be parked externally on a lot, and that no recreation vehicle or utility trailer is permitted to park in the front yard unless it's on a driveway, and that a recreational vehicle or utility trailer can be stored internally provided it is wholly contained within the dwelling unit, carport, or garage, and that the RV or trailer must have must be licensed, and that it can be parked in a side or a rear yard provided it has 1 meter within the fence. So let me just review that one more time so I can be perfectly clear.
Mm-hmm.
That it may be parked in a side or rear yard within 1 meter of the fence or property line, and if it's parked on a driveway, it must have a setback of 1 meter from the sidewalk or the curb. And also, of course, we've gone now to the 8 different days. Council did decide to, for a more balanced approach, to permit the temporary parking or storage on the driveway up to no more than 8 days. And that can be consecutive or not within the same calendar month. Now, there is one more provision that is included in the bylaw, which talks about the rear lot line or side yard in those cases where the property abuts a street. And that talks about the also a reserve, a 3 meter reserve or a 0.3 meter reserve. And it does say that it cannot be closer than 7.6 meters from the exterior or rear lot line. And this bylaw will be posted online, Mr. Mayor, so it will be available, and staff would be glad to answer any further questions from residents if the bylaw is passed this evening.
Great. Thank you. Councillor Twinney.
Thank you. And thank you to our Deputy Laurie for coming back again and speaking to this. It's certainly
I think you've made some really good valid points. And some other valid points that were made, I think, by some other deputants last week at Committee of the Whole was with regards to the fact that that these vehicles are licensed, legal vehicles to have. And, you know, as a homeowner, if you're having it there, again, I really stand by the fact that it is your, it is a recreational vehicle that's your on your property, and you should be able to have it there. I really do. I really believe that. And I've certainly had quite a few emails on both sides of this issue, but a lot from residents that really do support having the ability to have their recreational vehicle there when they're using it, like seasonal. And I think you make a really good point regarding the fact that you're not storing it there, you're parking it there, because you're using it, you're parking it, and then you're leaving and going on a vacation with your family with it at various times during that season. So I certainly think it's you make some valid points. I don't know what support I have with my colleagues, about going into that direction. I do feel that, and why I did support the 8-day was I thought it was a good compromise, and that's why I did end up supporting it, because I didn't want to see that fall through, because I felt that at least that gave a little bit more ability for residents to have a little bit more time with their recreational vehicles, and I certainly want to hear from some of my other colleagues. But again, I think there's more, there's other issues with regards to property standards that I think that are a greater concern than having a recreational pop-up, pop-up trailer and parked on your driveway or a small boat. Things like people that have garbage and around their property or don't cut their grass. I think those are greater concern than somebody having just their small trailer there for their use for their family. So I'm glad you came back again, Lori, and again, I am supportive of it being seasonal, but that being said, I don't know if there's a support there to go forward that way, but if there isn't, then I do support the 8 days. Thank you.
Thank you. Regional Councillor.
Yeah, a similar note, Lori. I give you a lot of credit and a lot of respect for being as engaged as you've been and coming back time and time again and reaching out to others, and that's part of the democratic process, and I congratulate you for that. As you alluded to, it's not always easy for council to find the balance that the committee wants to reach. And just for the public who is viewing, this will take our will allow for what was before a 72-hour restriction to 8-day restriction per month, and it's going to allow for larger vehicles by and large in driveways for use by people with recreational vehicles of any nature. And so, I mean, in many ways, you could look at it as we're kind of doubling the permissiveness of what we had before. I have had a number of conversations, discussions, emails with people, and I have to say for myself, and it's been different, but a significant portion have been concerned about allowing, becoming too permissive and allowing what could potentially be a proliferation of vehicles in driveways. And part of what we do at the town is we try to also look out for what kind of visual impact in the community, and so we regulate signs because you don't want signs all over town. And different things we try to do to maintain that. But I do want to stress for people who are watching this, like almost all of our bylaws, this is on a complaint only basis. So this isn't all of a sudden there's going to be somebody coming around to your house. If there's an issue, a neighbor can bring it to the attention of the town, and then it will be looked into and acted upon. But by and large, it's the only thing that's different today than it was a couple of months ago is that. If you do have an issue and somebody does complain, you've got more latitude or more ability to store your vehicle than you did before. And so hopefully we've reached a reasonable compromise that allows people to enjoy their vehicles more than they did before, but still respects the quite large number of residents I think others have and I've heard from that are concerned about the visual impact in their neighborhoods. So hopefully this is not is perfect for everybody, but it's something we can work with for now. Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Kerwin.
I will be supporting the bylaws presented tonight. It was a compromise. I favored 6 days, but we went to 8 days. I can accept that. And also, we took out the antiquated wording of the old bylaw, the length, and we have now the setback rather than that. So I got my compromise in there. So I will be supporting the bylaw. I think we've come up with quite a reasonable bylaw, and we have changed it in two areas. Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Broome-Plumley.
Thank you. And thank you, Laurie, again for coming in. Seasonal storage of smaller vehicles maybe should have been something that we dug a little deeper into, and I agree with your point tonight, and I wish we had had that point when we had this discussion last week. However, moving to 8 days seemed like a considerable change, and I hope it provides you some comfort for your needs. I appreciate your time and efforts, and I thank you once again for your passion in the matter, but I too will be supporting the current bylaw as it stands.
Thank you. Any further comments, observations? I'll call the question then. All those in favor? And this is a recorded vote. It's got a bit of a glitch here.
We can say yes and then we'll record it as such, but.
Okay.
We'll take that as
a I'll take that. Have we got the numbers cut there? Do we have the results other than mine? There we are. Okay. So that's carried. Thank you. Okay. Next item then is the approval of the minutes of the special committee of the whole minutes, June 22nd, and this is for confirmation only. I believe these were Councillor Kerwin, Councillor Sponga. All those in favor? Yeah, buttons again. Count me as a yes when this is working, okay, Chrisanne? Okay. And I see that has carried as well. Thank you. Next item is the special committee of the whole or special council meeting of September 14th. Any corrections? Motion then to adopt, to approve these. Councillor Vague, Councillor Kerwin. All those in favor? And that is carried. Thank you. Next item then is the special council closed session of September 14th, and this is for confirmation. Councillor Kerwin, Councillor Mizans, all those in favor? Item number four is the council minutes of September the 14th.
Order, please. Order.
Item number four, council minutes of September the 14th. Can I have a move? Councillor Vague? Councillor Sponga? All those in favor? We have no correspondence or petitions, reports by regional representatives. Regional Councillor.
Thanks very much. A couple things I want to highlight. Tonight for the people in the audience and the viewing audience as well and the members of council. This past week, we opened a new regional facility called the Bill Fish Center for Forest Stewardship and Education. This facility is out at south of Mulock on Highway 48. And it's an amazing facility. It's not a large facility, and it's meant to be used for managing some of our forestry work out of, but also to handle students and educational opportunities. The facility itself is not only LEEDS Platinum, but it meets the living building standard, of which only there are 8 buildings currently in the world that meet this standard. So that means that this building has all of its power needs and its water needs met within a closed system on site. It's also made from harvested materials and from naturally harvested materials that are sustainable and using smaller caliper trees that are regrown continuously so that it's a sustainable form of forestry harvesting. So it's really quite an amazing facility. I hope many people start to hear about it, at least from their kids when they get educational opportunities, and if anyone has a chance to go out and see it, it's a truly impressive building and facility. The other thing I just wanted to raise was that We did at Regional Council have an extensive presentation on our roads capital construction program update. The presentation was a very long overview, but it highlighted that over the next 10 years, we're going to see an investment of nearly $1.5 billion in York Region in improving the capacity of our road network and the state of good repair of our roads. And so $1.2 billion is in growth-related projects, but $270 million of that is in maintenance and renewal for road rehabilitation. That will be a 33% increase over last term of council. And this is an area we've realized we need to focus on more heavily due to levels of congestion that we're seeing and that is being seen throughout the GTA. This report is online and people can see it there, but I would want to highlight also that in this term of office, we are either seeing or have seen in the town of Newmarket, and it's been highlighted in this report as well, we've either seen work such as is going on in Bathurst Street, the extension to go to parallel Yonge Street North through into Simcoe County, and that is hopefully being completed in late 2016. We also seen work on Main Street North and the second concession that impacts Newmarket, and that is ongoing, was part of this report. And we're going to see work in the future on portions of Leslie. That's very shortly coming our way in the south end of Newmarket. We'll also see work on Bayview Avenue and, as I said earlier, the completion of Bathurst, but also a substantial project coming our way on Yonge Street North. And so Newmarket will also benefit from substantial work, which will improve not only capacity, intersection functioning, but just the general state of the road and the attractiveness and appearance of the boulevard. So that report is there for anybody who would like to see it. It's extensive, but it does give a clear sense of the kind of investments that are being made to make sure we're ready for the growth that the next decade will see. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Any questions? Next item then is the reports of committees and staff. First item is the council workshop of September 21st, and that was with respect to proactive assessment management in York Region's transit and the Viva Next overview. I have a motion to approve those notes. Councillor Broome-Plumley, Councillor Spongen, Councillor Broome-Plumley, all those in favor? Carried. Next item is the council workshop of September 28th, and that was with respect to an overview of Newmarket Tay Power and an outline of the customer first initiative that they're working with. Could I have a motion to receive those minutes as well? Absolutely. Councillor Sponga, Councillor Bizantz, all those in favor? And that is carried. Thank you. Next item then is the Committee of the Whole minutes of September 28th. We have already dealt with item number 14 earlier as a result of the deputation that we've received. Are there any items that members wish dealt with separately? Councillor Sponga?
I just want to speak to number 16 very, very briefly, Mr. Mayor.
Number 16.
It's okay. Dealing with the cycling infrastructure. Hope I have the right number.
All right, thank you. Any other items? Could I have a motion then to approve the minutes and the recommendations of the Committee of the Whole with the exceptions of item number 14 and 16? Councillor Bizantz, Councillor Sponga, all those in favor? And that is carried. Thank you. Item number 14 has been dealt with. Item number 16.
I move the recommendations, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. And we have a seconder. Councillor Kerwin. Okay. Councillor Sponga.
Yes, Mr. Mayor. I think this is somewhat exciting news. It's the first phase of moving forward with our east-west cycling connection. We've heard from many, many residents how much they enjoy our trails and our trail connections, but we're still lacking an east-west cycling route. and I think within our own urban roads, secondary roads, and I think this is a great step forward. I just want to reassure the residents of Ward 5 that this is pertaining to Millard Avenue, but this is the first phase just to allocate some funds and move forward with a funding application. But there will be extensive public consultation, and we'll still have to go through a design process where the public will have an opportunity to consult. So I just wanted to bring that point to light. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilor Kerwin is the seconder.
That's fine.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. Thank you. Any further comments? All those in favor? That is carried. Thank you. That deals with the Committee of the Whole, with the exception of the closed session minutes of September 28th. Could I have a motion that the Committee of the Whole closed session minutes of September 28th be approved? Councillor Bay?
Second.
Councillor Sponga? All those in favor? There were two items on the agenda. The first item is with respect to report number 2015-7, and it regarded a proposed pending acquisition and or disposition of land, and it related to an exchange of land between the town of Newmarket and the regional municipality of York. The recommendation was that the report be received and that staff proceed as outlined. Could I have a motion to that effect, please?
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
Councillor Kerwin? Councillor Bazance? Okay, thank you. All of those in favor? The second item related to the potential disposition of lands, and that was relative to the Hollingsworth Arena. And the report number 2015-54 involved some legal advice. And the matter was deferred to the October 20th Committee of the Whole closed session for further discussion. The recommendations then was to defer and also that staff proceed as directed. Could I have a motion to that effect, please?
So moved.
Councillor Sponga? Councillor Kerwin? All those in favor? Is carried. Next item is bylaws. Are there it's bylaws number 2015, 45, 46, 47, and 48. Does any member of council wish to have any of these bylaws dealt with separately? Okay. Mr. Clerk, if you could read the bylaws.
Mr. Mayor, 2015-45 is a bylaw to appoint an integrity commissioner for the town of Newmarket. Bylaw 2015-46 is a noise bylaw exemption, and that's related to Viva Next D1 Works. 2015-47 is the amendment to the zoning bylaw with respect to recreational vehicles, and bylaw 2015-48 amends the parking bylaw to prohibit parking at any time on the west side of Patty McCullough Way between number 88 and number 90, north to Woodspring Avenue.
Okay, can I have a mover for the bylaws, please? Councillor Bazance, Councillor Broome-Plumley. All those in favor? And that carries. Any notices of motion? Regional Councillor?
Yeah, I'll just provide notice that at the next cycle, next Committee of the Whole, I'll be bringing forward a motion in relation to outdoor arena in the town of Newmarket.
Thank you. Any motions? Let's go to then community events. We'll start with Councillor Vague.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. Just a reminder to Ward 1 residents that tomorrow evening, which Tuesday, October 6th, I'll be holding my monthly Ward 1 community drop-in. We hold this drop-in on the main floor at the Magna Center from 7 in the evening to about 7, till 9 o'clock. This is an opportunity for Ward 1 residents to come by to say hello, express your concerns and your ideas, and talk about things that are happening in our ward and in our town. So I'm looking forward to seeing my neighbors in Ward 1 at my drop-in tomorrow night at the Magna Center.
Thank you. Councillor Kerwin.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I also will be having a drop-in on three Saturdays in October. October the 17th, the 24th, and the 31st. This is at the Newmarket Public Library on Park Avenue. And I am there from 9:30 until 12 noon, and that is in the basement. And it's mainly for residents of Ward 2, but I'm beginning to find that other members of the community drop in, and I enjoy it thoroughly. And in November, I will be starting my fireside chats, which is normally on Sunday night, and I hold that in my home at 317 Maple Street. Enjoy Friday night social dances on October the 9th and 16th from 8 to 11 p.m. at the Newmarket Seniors Meeting Place, 474 Davis Drive. Come out for line dancing, ballroom dancing, Latin dancing, and more. The cost is $5 for members and $6 for non-members. Coffee and light snacks are provided, in addition to a cash bar. Call 905-953-5325 for more information. That's 905-953-5325. And I must say, as the council rep to the seniors meeting place, the membership is increasing, and it's up to about 1,200 now, and I congratulate the members and the staff, and particularly Kathleen Wilms, for accommodating the residents who go out to the seniors meeting place because, as you know, we've had a lot of construction on Davis Drive. But the membership is coming right back up to where it was before the construction started, and I'm happy to report that.
Thank you. Councillor Twain.
Thank you. Must be time of year for ward meetings. I'm announcing tonight about my ward meeting that I'm holding on October the 14th. It will be at the Newmarket Community Center in Lyons Hall again, and at 200 Duncan Drive. It runs from 7 till about 8:30, and we'll have some topics to discuss and then an open session at the end. I look forward to seeing everybody there. If you have anything that you want to discuss with me, please contact me directly at my email, jtwinney@newmarket.ca, or you can call me on my cell, 905-806-5258. Thank you.
Thank you. Regional Councillor.
Thanks very much. This past Saturday was the electronic waste recycling event that I host each year. And I want to just thank Newmarket Environmental Advisory Committee for the work they do and volunteering they do at this event. Upper Canada Mall for allowing us to use their space, and Artex Environmental for being the doing a lot of the work and taking the waste and dealing with it. So we had 14,000 pounds of e-waste that was diverted this year in a five-hour period. That brings our total to about 161,000 pounds of e-waste that's been diverted from landfill in developing countries over the past 4 or 5 years. So really want to thank the residents of Newmarket who take the time to participate and use this option, because it's an important initiative that we and we're just finding it's getting more and more successful. And other Aurora now does it, East Quillenbury does it, and I think it's making a significant impact environmentally in our area and certainly in other areas. So thank you to everybody for participating. The other thing I wanted to just bring to people's attention, for those who don't know, tomorrow night is the election debate that the Chamber of Commerce is putting on at the Newmarket Theater. I want to thank the Chamber of Commerce and their volunteer board of directors for putting this event on. It's a very important opportunity for people to learn more about what's going on in the federal election and the local candidates. I urge those who can attend to do so, and I urge everybody to please get out and vote. This is, like all elections, important, and there's certainly issues that are important to this municipality and to the residents of Newmarket. So, again, the debate is tomorrow night. 6 o'clock to 7 o'clock is a Meet the Candidates kind of open house in the foyer of the theater, and then 7 o'clock the debate begins. That's at the Newmarket Theater, 505 Pickering Drive. Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Sponga.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. We are. This is Thanksgiving month, and we're quickly approaching our Thanksgiving weekend. And what a better way to give thanks by giving food to those who don't have. And the town of Newmarket is starting has just started their fall food drive, and food non-perishable items can be dropped off here at 395 Mulock in the lobby. And if you have any, and that goes on until October 19th. If you have any information, you can call our customer service desk if you need any information at 905-895-5193, or the Newmarket Food Pantry at 905-895-6823. I want to take this opportunity to thank the many volunteers and many donors that are partaking at this time in a number of food drives, but I want to specifically thank the students and the families at Pickering College that have been involved in food drive now for the last couple of weeks, and they've already filled about 50 crates, and they've just called the food bank today to ask for another 50 more to fill. So kudos to all the families, students, schools, and organizations that are partaking in this, and of course the staff at the Town of Newmarket. Thank you so much. And I take this opportunity to wish our viewers and our audience and staff and members of council happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you. Councilor Brimpumley.
Thank you. This past week, we here in Newmarket celebrated the 35th annual Terry Fox Run. I just wanted to give a tremendous shout out to the volunteers, Lori Osborne and her team, for raising close to $90,000. I found that it was a tremendous effort, and I appreciated being a part of it. In addition, come on out to the 9th annual Princess and Pirate Party. Enjoy live entertainment, crafts, fun games, face painting, jumping castles, train rides, music, dancing, loot bags, and theme activities. Dress as a princess or a pirate for an outdoor parade. Admission is $5 per child. Parents and guardians are free. And along the same lines of ward meetings, I have my monthly meeting coming up on Wednesday, October the 21st, at the Newmarket Public Library at 438 Park Avenue between 7 and 9 p.m. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilor Bazans.
Thank you very much. And just like to also start off with thanking those residents who attended the special public information session on the council code of conduct. This is a very important issue, I think, to make sure that moving forward we have a code that we can all not just abide by, but that really reflects the direction that council members need to be taking and considering. It was an important opportunity for the public to come out and be engaged in. I want to particularly express my appreciation to one young lady who found out about the event through reading in the local paper and asked her father to attend because she's very concerned about civics, but most importantly because she's concerned for her future and the future of her colleagues. She's 12 years old, and I have to say that her input into that session was phenomenal and really is something that a lot of adults probably couldn't have matched. So thank you to her if she's watching this evening. In addition, I want to tell you about the Create a Victorian Costume two-day workshop that's being held at the Elman Campbell Museum, 134 Main Street South, from 1:30 to 3:30 on Saturday, October 17th and Saturday, October 24th. It's an opportunity for either men and women 18 years and over to learn about historic fabrics and see examples from museum collections. You can discover heritage patterns, how to source fabrics, and put together materials from a thrift shop. Consult with an experienced reenactment seamstress on using patterns to create your own Victorian costume. The workshop is $75 for residents and $100 for non-residents. Registration is online at newmarket.ca using Quick E-Link. For more information, call 905-953-5314 or email elmanmuseum@rogers.com.
Thank you. Planning is underway for the Town of Newmarket's 2016 budget. Get involved and tell us how you'd like to see your tax dollars spent by completing our online interactive budget survey at newmarket.ca/budget2016. Additional opportunities for feedback on the 2016 budget are also available through our public meetings. We also had a booth at the Farmers Market on Saturday, and we received some terrific feedback, and it was good to have the perspective direct through the one-on-one discussions that we had there. Our next public meeting with respect to the budget will be the presentation of the preliminary draft budget at the Committee of the Whole on Tuesday, October the 20th at 1:30 at the Council Chambers. Now, you can also view that meeting, as you can this meeting, online on our website, which is newmarket.ca. Then you would click on Town Government, then on Council Meetings, then on Agendas, Minutes, and Meetings, and that will take you to the streaming of this. You're right. I think we've got to find a way that could be a more direct link. But that's where it stands now, and it's still an opportunity if the timing isn't good, and it helps give people an opportunity to see what the dialogue is about. Please be advised that the Town of Newmarket Municipal Offices at 395 Mulock will be closed on Thanksgiving Day, Monday, October the 12th, and that our next council meeting is on Monday, October the 26th at 7 p.m. Is there any new business? Councillor Kerwin.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, I do, and this is directed to John Parquette, who came out to the public meeting a Monday ago with regard to the cemetery lands. I had the opportunity to walk the lands with him again, and I'm pleased to say that Rick Nethery has presented me with a map of the lands around that area, and I'm delighted to say that the town owns the riverlands along the river, which you someday could put a trail system through there. So, John, thanks for that personal tour. It was rewarding, and I saw some sites that I hadn't seen for a long time. So we own the land, John. The second item is I was walking home today from a meeting this morning north on the Tom Taylor Trail, and I urge the residents to do this. I looked up on the hill where all the trees have been planted in remembrance of people, and it looked absolutely gorgeous. Indian summer has come. So if you're walking along that trail, if you leave the town offices and you go on the Tom Taylor Trail north, you will see something absolutely spectacular. And that's been there for about 20 years now, and the trees are mature and the trees are turning. The other thing is we had a storm down at the Newmarket Community Tennis Courts on Sunday because of the closing of Timber Lane, but there's still outdoor tennis. Courts 4, 5, and 6 are open in October, and there's some good tennis weather coming up. But I congratulate Recreation and Culture for the new format that they put in at the tennis courts at Peter Gorman. They are absolutely superb. So if you're a tennis player and you haven't used them, get out and use them. In fact, it will improve your tennis because the balls come up quicker than normal and your backswing has to be more accurate. So, Mr. McDougall and your department, that's a fantastic asset to the town. It really just complements the lawn bowling, the swimming pool, the basketball courts. Now we have terrific tennis courts. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's all, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. No additional new business. We did provide for a closed session if required. It is not required. And so I would ask for a motion with respect to the confirmatory bylaw.
So moved, Mr.
Councillor Sponga, Councillor Bazance. All those in favor. And that is carried. And motion to adjourn. Councillor Sponga. Councillor Kerwin. Any discussion? Recorded vote. All those in favor. Regional Councillor. There we go. And that is carried. Thank you very much.